keyboard shortcuts and adding additional keyboards. Sometimes you want to type the same thing over and over, and instead of typing your email address in full, typing a shortcut for your email address might be useful. The iPad has the ability to enter shortcuts, keyboard shortcuts. So instead of typing your password in full, you could type the shortcut key that will then input your full password for you. This can work for a number of different applications, like a Word document or a password to get into your email. To insert some shortcuts, tap Settings, General, Keyboard, and scroll down to the bottom to find the shortcuts. There may already be some shortcuts that are already set up for you. If so, you can edit them, delete them, or just add new shortcuts. To add a new shortcut, tap Add a new shortcut. Insert the phrase that you want the shortcut to represent. For example, I'm going to type my address in the phrase field. Instead of typing my address in full, I can then type the shortcut to represent that address. Tap the shortcut field and then come up with a shortcut. For my address, my shortcut will be ADR. Then tap the save button. The next time I need to enter my address, instead of typing it in full, I can just type ADR. Let's try it. Click the home button to get back to the home screen. Open a notes app and start a new note. You want to type your address. Instead of typing the whole address in full, just type the shortcut. For me, the shortcut was ADR. The shortcut comes up in a little bubble with the full address. To accept the suggested text, tap the space bar and the full address is inserted into the note for me. If I didn't want the shortcut's suggestion, tap the X in the bubble. Let's enter another shortcut. Hide the keyboard if it's still visible. Using four fingers, swipe up to get to the multitasking bar and select Settings again. Settings should have taken you back to the keyboard settings and the shortcuts should still be visible. Now add a new shortcut. This time we'll add an email address. Enter your email address in the phrase field. And in the shortcut field, enter a shortcut. For example, GM for a Gmail email address. Tap the save button. Tap the keyboard button to go back a screen and then tap Add New Shortcut. And this time we'll add a password. In the phrase field, enter your password for your Gmail account or any other email account you might have. And in the shortcut field, enter the shortcut for the email password, for example, PW. Test your shortcut. Swipe up with four fingers to get to the multitasking bar, select Notes app again. Find an empty space in the note to bring the keyboard up. Tap the return key a few times to get some space. Now let's test it. Type your shortcut for your address. In my case, that was ADR. Tap the space bar to accept the shortcut and then tap the return key. Type the shortcut for your email address. In my case, it's my Gmail address, so I'll tap GM and then tap return. Now type the shortcut for your email password. In my case, the shortcut for my email password is PW. Viewing your shortcuts. Back to settings. Tap the keyboard to go back a screen. And your list of shortcuts is listed in the middle of the screen. To edit a shortcut, type the shortcut you wish to edit, and then you can change the text in the phrase field. Let's change your address. I'm going to edit the suburb of my address. And then tap Save. Shortcuts are available wherever the virtual keyboard appears. So you could use them in notes, in emails, in Safari, in apps like Pages, anywhere that you need to type something. To delete a shortcut, tap the Edit button and your shortcuts will appear with red circles to the left of them. To delete a shortcut, tap the red circle and then on the right side of you'll see the Delete button. Delete the shortcut, it's gone, and then tap the Done button. Something a little bit different, adding a new keyboard. Sometimes you want to put in an emoticon, a little smiley face, some graphics, some large icons for numbers or buttons. And for this you can add a new keyboard. The iPad has the ability to add additional keyboards, and the Emoji keyboard, E-M-O-J-I, will provide emoticons and icons, and you can switch between the keyboards when you're typing emails, notes, contacts, anything that requires the keyboard. So how do we set up the Emoji keyboard? In Settings, tap General, Settings, International Keyboards. Tap Add a New Keyboard. Scroll down the list to Emoji and tap to select it. Now the keyboard is added. There are also other keyboards you might want to add. For example, Swedish, Italian. I'm going to add the Hebrew keyboard. So how do you use the Emoji keyboard? Back to the Notes app and create a new note. Tap anywhere in Notes to bring up the keyboard and you'll see a new key has been added to your keyboard. Next to the question mark 123 key, there is now a globe. Tap the globe key. And now there are a series of buttons which will give you different types of emoticons, graphics and icons. Tap the bell button. There are small graphics of such things as cameras and discs, letterbox, Christmas tree. Tap the car button for more pictures and images. Tap a picture or icon and it is inserted into whatever document or app you're in at the time. You can use the black cross key to delete the graphic if you've inserted the wrong one. Let's explore the buttons. The flower button gives you images of nature and animals. The smiley face button is for the emoticons. The exclamation mark, question mark, hash button has large arrows, numbers. The L button collects all the recently and frequently used icons, which may save you some time later on. How do you switch between the Emoji keyboard and normal keyboard? If you tap and hold the globe button, you can select between the Emoji mode and the English keyboard, and then you're back to your normal keyboard layout. If you just tap the globe button, it will alternate between both keyboards. If you've got more than one additional keyboard, you need to tap and hold. To turn off and delete any additional keyboards, tap Settings, General, International, then tap Keyboards. Edit. Tap the red circle to select the keyboard to be deleted and tap the Delete button, then tap Done.